Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Plants vs. Zombies. Last time we took on a few more levels in level 2, and we unlocked the Doom Shroom, which has proven to be an incredible plant. And this time, after receiving this note, we're heading into the last level of level 2. I don't know what to expect here. Let's see. A lot of zombies. And a lot of graves! Oh my god, is it another whack-a-mole? It's not a whack-a-zombie. Oh, it's one of these. Okay, well that's fine. We got a lot of more unique plants this time around. So, I'm actually gonna hold on to Fume Shroom, because we're probably gonna get something that can just, yeah, do that. Because we don't have to worry about sunflowers. We got a Doom Shroom, definitely gonna hold on to him. What we really need is, what do we need? Grave Buster. That's what we really need, so we got a lot of crap going on around here. You know what? We're not gonna need that. We're not gonna need that little section. Go ahead, turn around. Hypno Shroom's pretty good. For this mode anyway. Because you can just immediately turn them around. Scaredy Shroom, that's good. I'm gonna hold on to as many of these type of things as we can. Because they're going to be useful for, like, the bigger zombies. There we go. Let's get rid of the ones that are closest to our side. Another Doom Shroom. Oh, he's eating his friend. Okay. Ah, screw it. Let's drop a Doom Shroom. Boom! Because it's a screen nuke, after all. Oh, I guess I should have waited, since it is a screen nuke. But, oh well. Ice Shroom. Temporarily freeze everything. Get another Scaredy Shroom down. This isn't too bad. We've got 3 Doom Shrooms, so we literally have just 3 screen nukes sitting in reserve right there. Which is pretty incredible. What we really need now, though, is another Scaredy Shroom for over here. There we go, just when I needed it. Let's turn him around. Let's go ahead and use this. Freeze everybody for a little bit. Go to you. He's eating his friend over there. Another Ice Shroom. You know what? Screw it. We'll drop another Ice Shroom. Because we don't have a lot of offensive plants out right now, unfortunately. Because they're just not giving them to us. We have a lot of these, like, nuke ones. Nukes and Grave Busters and the Hypno Shrooms. But we don't have anything that's just shooting. There's our first Puff Shroom. Okay, I'm going to use another Ice Shroom right here. Because I'm trying to get rid of these guys. Well, now it's giving us more puff shrooms. I guess I'll put Hypno Shroom up here. Ooh, this row down here might be an issue, so we'll Hypno Shroom that guy. Yeah, because now we got a screen door on our side. He's just gonna be super defensive for us, which is great. Okay, we got more Doom Shrooms. I'm gonna just let him. Okay, I guess they don't shoot him when he's on our side. That makes sense. Oh, I can't do that right there. Is that where we dropped the Doom Shroom? I guess it is. You can't plant on craters. Didn't realize that. Well, I knew we couldn't plant on craters. I didn't realize that that was a crater. You know what? We've got enough. Just nuke the screen. And I guess some of these didn't count as being on screen yet. Oh god, I'm probably gonna drop another one right here. Yeah, let's do it. Boom! Or Doom, sorry. And I got a football player coming in. Did you just eat the grave? Wait, what was that? You know what? Turn around. Oh, I missed. Oh, screw it. Drop another Doom. There we go. Replace him. Get you down. We've still got 2 Doom Shrooms in reserve. That's good. We've got 2 rows of Scaredy Shrooms now, which is fantastic. I'm gonna try and see if we can Hypno Shroom this guy. That one, I guess. Sure. Freeze everybody. So that guy can finish his job. Beautiful. Get rid of that guy. Or that grave. We're almost done with this dude. Yeah, they got through his screen door. Okay. I was gonna say, which one of you is gonna win right here? Let's get you down and you down. I don't know if they're gonna defeat this guy in time. This could be a problem, so we'll do this. Yeah, send the football players back where they came from. We'll get you down here. Oh, there's a lot of zombies. I mean, this is like a boss level, so it kind of makes sense, but... Oh no, they're getting scared, I forgot. So it's if they're, like, super close to them that they get all scared like that, I suppose. I'm about to drop a screen nuke, honestly. Yeah, let's go for it. Boom! Man, it doesn't they're not counting as on-screen. I guess it didn't count for that guy either. That's weird. Okay, we got another Doom Shroom there. God damn it, I might just drop another. Boom! Get rid of all of them. So I guess it can't hit the row that's furthest away if you put it, like, down here. So I guess I need to place them, like, right in the middle for the best effect, I suppose. I'm gonna hold on to you. Because you never know where you're gonna want to put these. I'm gonna want to put it down here. I'm gonna put one right there to get rid of the football player. Freeze all the other zombies. Because now the football players are just gonna start just running through them. Absolutely just running through them. And we're done. Okay, let's drop these for the hell of it. Blow everything up. Yeah, that wasn't that bad. It took a while, but it wasn't that bad. And now, we unlock a very interesting plant. We get the lily pad. Lets you plant non-aquatic plants on top of it. What does that mean? It means we're going to the backyard. I accidentally spoiled this earlier.
Looks like the zombies gave up attacking your front yard. Now they're trying your backyard. And to top it off, you can't even use your mushrooms, because they fall asleep during the day. Well, isn't that just dandy?
Yep, our mushrooms are now no longer usable, and that includes Doom Shroom and- Oh, it even tells you, this entire row. That counts as a mushroom? Interesting. Well, that makes choosing what we're gonna need a little bit easier, because we literally cannot use any of these. It's interesting that the daytime plants don't fall asleep at night, but the nighttime ones do in the day. Anyway, pea shooter. We're gonna do... We'll do snow pea, then pea shooter. We'll do the walnut, we'll do the potato mine, and we will do the cherry bomb. Yeah, sure, we haven't used cherry bomb for a while, so why not? We have to have the lily pad because there's two rows here that are just water. So you need to have lily pads to be able to put this stuff on the water, because we don't have any aquatic plants yet. So for the time being, we have to rely on these little dudes. And also, I kind of forgot we were going to be having sunlight coming down from the sky now, and that's going to speed up the, like, time it takes for us to actually build, like, units, you know? It's going to be a lot better. I hope that's far enough away. I think it is. I want to say he was far enough away. I don't know. All right, let's build up some sunflowers. Please, please come out of the ground. Please, little buddy. Yes, ba-dow! All right. We still don't have any, like, offensive plants out, though, so I should probably do that. I guess, actually, we'll just walnut there for now. Because we can do that. We can just keep building up our sunflowers while our defenses get bolstered. And, of course, we're going to keep needing to put lily pads down as well. I guess I'll drop a potato mine right there for the hell of it. Why not? I'm unsure if potato mines can be put on lily pads. I'm actually kind of curious to test that out now. And of course, he comes on the freaking row that I put that guy on before he's gonna get to actually come out of the ground. That's just- Oh no, never mind, he's coming out of the ground. Cool. Spadow. Alright, I'm just gonna stick to the one row of sunflowers, I think. I don't believe we're gonna need a second row. Column. God damn it. There I go again. I don't believe we'll need a second column, but... maybe. Maybe I'll put- you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna put some more down. And more sun is better than less sun. And once we have a crazy amount of sun, we can always dig up these sunflowers, so it's kind of worth it. In my eyes, anyway. I don't know if this is a good strategy or not, but... in my eyes, it seems like a good one. I got a cherry bomb now, that's good. Let's put a pea shooter right here. Keep building up our sunflowers. That guy's gonna blow up. Keep building up our lily pads as well. The walnut down, we'll put a... I'm gonna let him get past. We'll put a potato mine. I kinda... Oh, I'm gonna need a snow pea or something. Oh, we'll just put another pea shooter for now. Ooh, I kinda let this guy get a little bit too close, and now this guy's gotten past our walnut. Ooh, pea shooter, please finish him off. Please finish him off. Okay. Oh, this is not going well. This is going poorly. There we go. That was almost really bad. That was almost super duper bad, I gotta say. Alright, let's do potato mine in front of the walnut. Why not? Pea shooter, right here. We've almost got our second row of second column of sunflowers completed. That guy blew up. It was honestly probably a waste of a potato mine, given we have this pea shooter right here, but that's okay. And you may have also noticed nothing has like shown up in the middle yet, and there they are, right on cue. God damn it, we got swimming zombies coming through. They still go at the same speed as a regular zombie, which is good. But, yeah, they're in the water. So that's fun, and they eat your lily pads. You know what? Oh, we can't put potato mines on it. I mean, that makes sense. It'd be kind of weird if you could do that, but still, I wanted to give it a try. I wanted to give it a try. I should have put the snow pea here. Actually, no, because we didn't have anything on the bottom row, so never mind. Never mind. All right, we're looking pretty good right now. I put the walnuts, like, way far over to the right for some reason. It's not necessarily a bad thing that they're that far over, because it stops the zombies further away from us. Okay, let's see. Oh, we're on the final wave already. Okay. It did not feel like we were on the final wave. Just gonna drop a cherry bomb right there, get rid of a couple. Put another pea shooter there. And I think we're okay. I mean, this is the first level of level 3, so I wasn't really expecting it to be too difficult. But, yeah, we just gotta get rid of these two, and then we're good. So let's just put another pea shooter down, and then they should finish them off. Yeah, that was honestly rather tame. I'm at a loss for words. That was a rather tame wave after what we've just been dealing with in the nighttime levels. And now we got my favorite plant. Absolutely probably my most favorite plant in this game. The squash. Squashes zombies. It's as simple as that. I always bring this guy with me. And you're gonna see exactly why. He only costs 50. And he's incredibly useful. Super duper useful. So we're gonna do snow pea again. I kinda wanna bring repeater just because we haven't really used him much. Yeah, sure, we're gonna risk this. Cause now we have squash as well. So we'll do walnut, squash. And I guess we could also just do regular pea shooter, but no, we're gonna do potato mine again. Maybe I'm gonna regret not bringing the cherry bomb, but we'll see. Alright, not lily pad, sunflower down first, so we can be getting more sun. The squash is, think of it like a cherry bomb, but it costs way less. It doesn't have as big of a blast radius because it doesn't explode, but it can still kill multiple zombies at once if they're, like, fairly close to each other. For example, if you get a bunch of zombies, like, chewing on a walnut, the squash can kill all of them because they're all, like, stacked on top of each other, so... It's pretty damn good, and it only costs 50 sun. It takes a little bit to recharge. Like, it's not the quickest recharge out there. But it's by no means slow either, so... It's a pretty damn good plant, if you ask me. If I do say so myself. Now, I want to put another potato mine down for this guy. But he's not quite there yet, so let's just show off squash. Yep. It does exactly what it says on the tin, and it... squashes. So, yep, that's what it does. It's a squash and it squashes zombies. And as you can see, it recharges decently fast. So, it's really, it's an, like, just a really good plant to bring with you to, like, pretty much any level, in my opinion. It's really, really good. Now, I'm gonna stop worrying about lily pads for now. I'm just gonna keep focusing on getting more sunflowers out and walnuts because we want to bolster our defenses. Well, actually, that's about to come back. So we'll put a walnut here. Get some sunflowers down. And then once potato mine is back, I'm gonna put it, like, right over here so this guy just walks into it. Because I just want to keep building up our sunflowers for now. And I guess I'll start doing a couple more lily pads. And then actually, we'll put a squash behind the walnut. I probably could have waited, like, stalled it out for a little bit, but that's fine. Yeah, we got that guy coming as well. Alright, snow pea. Right down here. Let's keep building up these sunflower columns. Let me know in the comments as well, do you think it's beneficial for me to build up two columns of sunflowers on the day levels? Because I said that I wasn't going to do that, and then I've been doing it anyway. So I'm genuinely curious on your opinions on that, because it's not something I ever really did when I played this on my iPod back in the day. It's something I've started doing since doing this Let's Play, so let me know what you think. Like, I legitimately just want opinions on this. Alright, okay, cool. Mini games unlocked, play them from the main menu. I was wondering when we were gonna get those. Because they've been sitting there on the main menu, we just haven't been able to actually play them, so that's cool. We are going to be including all of the minigames in this Let's Play. We're going to finish the story mode first, and then... Oh, we can't do anything with that middle row. What am I doing? Middle row. I actually said row correctly that time. Yeah, we are going to be covering the minigames. We're going to finish Adventure first before we do that. But I do fully intend on covering them. So I'm pretty excited for that. There's a good amount of them too. And they're not exactly... They're not all short, you know? So I'm kind of excited. I don't know if I've ever beaten them all. So that's going to be fun. It's going to be real fun. Okay, so once we've got our last snow pea out down here, it should happen any second now. I'm gonna start focusing on repeaters, but also walnuts. And then what I like to do is, right behind walnuts, I like to put a squash. Because then if any zombie actually manages to get to where the walnuts are, they're gonna die to the squash. It's like the squash is like, hey, don't come any closer. I'm gonna put him right here. This guy's not gonna get over here. But if he does, the squash will have a thing to say about it. And then we'll put potato mines in front as well, in case squash doesn't feel like doing it. I don't know. I don't really know what I'm saying now, but... Okay, let's wait before we put that guy down, because I want to see where they're coming from. Let's see where the heaviest row is. I guess probably down here, looks like. Maybe the water. It's fine. We'll be fine. We will be A-okay. You know what? Nope, repeater. Here, keep getting our sun. We're doing pretty good. We've got to say we're only like halfway through this level. We have a good amount of plants up, so I'm pretty happy with where we're at right now. I do want this last walnut to finish charging though. The potato mine. Who's screaming? Who was that? Somebody's out here just going, "Arr!" I don't even know who that was. No, you're mad, are you? Well, that's too bad, buddy. That is too bad. Repeater comes back pretty quickly, actually. Well, it comes back super quickly. I didn't realize that. So maybe it is better to bring that in than pea shooter. Or maybe like pea shooter and repeater, because pea shooters get out a bit quicker. I don't know. That's something to think about, because it recharges a lot faster than I thought it would. And if that is the case... It's gonna, like, once we've got our two columns of sunflowers out, we can quite easily get a bunch of repeaters, so maybe it's worth it. I'm not sure. Maybe. Pretty much at this point, all I want to do is get out more squashes. Squashes and one more potato mine. But this is a really good defense right now. Ah, hello, Buckethead. I was wondering when we're gonna see another one of you. It's been a little bit. Okay, we'll get the potato mine down here, and then it's just a case of getting two squashes down, and we've got this place looking mighty pretty. But look how much sun we have. We have a crazy amount of sun, so it's probably beneficial for me to start putting other stuff down. Yeah, probably. I'm gonna take out a column of sunflowers and replace them with repeaters, because then we're just gonna be decimating absolutely everything. And I guess they did actually end up using up that, that potato mine up there. I didn't even notice. I legitimately didn't even notice that guy had been defeated, but I guess it was the bucket head, probably. Oh, potato mine right there. Repeater right here. Get that guy up. Okay, we are doing great. We are doing really good in this level. Oh, don't make it to the potato mine. I don't want him to blow up yet. Okay, huge wave is approaching. That is fine. Because we're about to have everything out that I wanted. Another squash. A repeater right here. Oh god, I forgot they can do that. But that's why we have squashes. They can just come out of the water at any given place if they choose to. And that's why we have squashes right there, folks. That is why we want them. Look at this. We have destroyed in this one. This couldn't have gone much better, honestly. This was a really good setup. I'm actually pretty impressed with myself, but now, right after I get some use out of repeater, we're about to get something else. I think you can probably tell what it's called just from looking at it. Three-peater shoots peas in three lanes. Yeah, let's go back to the main menu, because we're not going to jump into the next level just yet, and take a look here. I guess there's no, like, demo of it, but it shoots in the row that it's in, the one that's above it, and the one that's below it. But as you can see, it costs 325 sun. It's a little expensive. Also, he enjoys going to shows, particularly modern jazz. I'm just looking for that special someone, he says. His favorite number is 5. Okay, cool. With that, folks, that is going to do it for this episode of Plants vs. Zombies. Next time, we'll be heading back into the adventure and taking on level 3-3 and probably a couple more after that. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And, of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.